Hey everybody, welcome to Active Self-Protection Extra. Gosh, I introduced this at SHOT Show this year in January, but I finally have my hands on a Blackbeard Mantis. I've got about 5,000 trigger presses on one, so I want to talk to you about that as a gear review today. Big Tech's Outdoors has holsters, accessories, optics, and other parts that you need as a self-defender. I'm one of his customers and I recommend him highly. Check out the page on our website with our favorite deals. So we're here at C2 Tactical. You can hear some shooting going on in the next bay. And you go, John, this is a dry fire tool. Why do you have it here at the live fire range? Well, I verified the zero on this guy here just a minute ago. And I want to show you what this guy is, what it does, why it makes you a better shooter, and how you can use it. So here's the cool part of this. It is simply a bolt replacement. So you can see the bolt carrier here. All I did was pop the bolt and charging handle out of this gun. Again, this is my Texas TX-15 Lone Star Armory gun. Put a new bolt in it, and then the magazine replacement, and the magazine is actually the battery. And I don't know how many thousands of trigger presses the battery is good for, because I've done about 8,000 on this and it's still going strong. I did around 5,000 in the first one, and then I did 3,000 before that, and then I charged it. So I don't know how many are actually good about this. It lasts forever. So, and it's a USB charger. That's kind of cool, is if I pop this out, you can see here, it's just battery connections on that. And it has a little micro USB charging port. But again, I haven't done a whole lot of charging with it because it doesn't really need it. Now you can kind of hear, you hear that clickety clickety. And one of the interesting things that you're going to see here is that if I'm going to just kind of give you a little bit of nifty part. One of the things this thing does is basically what it does is it resets the trigger. So listen in, you're gonna hear actually two clicks. So you go click and then it resets. So it's my gun, my sighting system, my trigger. And when I press the trigger, it instantly resets it and then I get a reset. Now the cool part of that for dry fire with your rifle is, the biggest problem of dry firing with a rifle is it takes you forever to reset, right? Is that you go click, dismount the gun, run the charging handle, reset everything. Up, click, reset. This now, I can actually run my gun and do multiple shot strings, and I can even do single shots and all those things, and it runs the and resets the trigger, so I get a lot more work done with my rifle in dry fire much quicker. I know some people are gonna ask, how fast does it reset? I know they did a test with Jerry Michalek, and Jerry couldn't outrun the trigger reset, which, I mean, I'll tell you something, because Jerry is a human bump fire. It's certainly faster than I am. And the other part of that that's kind of interesting is that people will say, well, it sounds weird. So you go click, click, click. So it's like three quick clicks, one, two, three. Now you go, that feels weird. Well, it actually feels like that when you fire the gun live fire, but you'll never feel it because the gun's recoiling and you just had the concussion of the round going off downrange. So it takes a little bit of getting used to, but I mean, again, all you're doing is click. Now the trigger has reset as fast as it would under recoil. Now your trigger resets and your sear resets. So you actually hear and feel three, but I can show you a couple of other interesting things here. The unit also, what I'll do is I'll show you here is, if you're looking at the middle target, you can see the fact that it shoots a green laser. That's useful if you are going to use a laser trainer or you're just trying to spot your shots. I think the super useful thing is I'm running a 1.93 spur mount here on this guy, and it reminds me of my height over bore at various distances. So we're standing here at about 14 yards, so it's pretty close to dead on, dead even. But if I was running at 10 yards, then I am going to be below my point of aim. And because I'm below my point of aim, then, which I should be, right? Because I have height over bore. It reminds me of that, helps me do that in live fire. Now, I know when we say, wait a minute, but John, on the regular laser trainers, you don't like those because they make people look over their sights. True, but not through an optic. In an optic, you're actually still looking through the optic to see what's going on. So I think it's a useful tool. One of the things that it does, I'm just going to leave you right there because, again, I've been shooting some. I did a private lesson. We've got some videos on that. Is the fact that now what I can do here is I can go, oh, okay, there's a target, bang, and now I transition to a second target, bang, third target, bang, and I can do the same exact things without having to reset my trigger every time. So if you see me do that with a little bit of speed here, not a ton, but just a little bit, And you go, okay, wait a minute, John. So that wasn't maybe the world's greatest effort, but you could see me do it, right? So again, I can go back to this dry fire and I can come back and say, well, maybe here at this range, I have this particular A zone. Great, got that. Okay, great. So I can do target transitions. I can do multiples on a single target, right? So if I'm in this middle one and I go shooter up, quick build drill, okay, fine. Now, of course, I'm not getting any recoil, right? This is a dry fire unit, which then you'd go to the live fire range and verify. But in this time when ammo is so crazy expensive, now, I will say, I think this guy with the green laser in it and the battery, the green laser unit's like $250. But guys, like, 223 ammo is like 75 cents a round right now. So, I mean, shoot, that's not all that many rounds. You're talking about 300 to 400 rounds of ammunition and you've paid for it. And like I say, another cool thing about this is now that I have it pulled out, now it's a training tool. Now, I still would be cautious with it, wouldn't mess around with it, those kinds of things. We have blue guns for a reason. But for instance, this guy completely taken apart, I actually took my bolt and my bolt carrier and put it in the safe because I have unauthorized accessors in my home, but now it's not a gun. It can't be loaded. It can't be used because the bolt is no good. They'd have to go into my safe, get the bolt and all that stuff. So I can leave this guy out as a dry fire tool and dry fire with him all the time. And I've been doing it. So I think you could also, you could put your Mantis on a rail and do good stuff with that. So guys, yeah, great tool. Let me use it a little bit more. Super good tool, dig it.